It's wonderful to be back, Mark.
Oh, yes. This is Alan J. Redbear, our undaunted producer, we can say. And they're yelling down there, no sound, but they don't have the monitor turned up. Go turn the monitor up. This is Alan J. Redbear, and he's back for another exciting... How long are you going to be back with us for?
I'll be back forever. Forever.
This is Duane Fatel over here. He's on audio, and he almost forgot to remind us to put our mic on.
Little back porch humor there.
We're live for 4 hours tonight here at Group W Cable in Dearborn, Channel 31. And look at this playlist. Awesome. Awesome playlist. Starting off with the Eurythmics in a block with the Rocky Horror Picture Show, The Time Warp. And this is, if you can relate to this, you can relate to Hardcore Teddy Turner. So just give it your best shot. We're going to roll right into this traditional block here. Starting off with the Eurythmics. Take it away, Duane and Alan.
Let's do The Time Warp.
Yeah, let's do it again.
Right now?
Yeah.
Right in front of everyone?
Nah, well, okay, forget it. Give us a call at 271-2600. And requests and dedications are welcome, so call us in and tell us what you want to hear. And also, Back Porch Video is played taped in some of your cable systems. I think about 14 cable systems now. And give us some calls and requests and dedications when they play, because there are answering machines awaiting your calls. And leave the requests. We'll be glad to try and get them on for you the next week or so. Before we roll into John Fogerty and Centerfold, we want to Centerfield. That was Jay Giles or whatever. Yeah, we're way behind here. Who went to Howard Jones' concert yesterday? See, this is live Saturday evening, and who went yesterday? Did anyone go here? You wanted to? I heard it was terrific. It was at Pine Knob, and they had a beautiful night for a concert, kind of warm and all that kind of stuff. If you saw him. And if you liked him or whatever, give us a call and tell us how he was, because I like to talk about it. I like to hear what you thought of him. Should we roll into John Fogerty?
I'd love to roll into John Fogerty.
Well, then roll into it.
Center field.
What a wonderful thing. Now, those are the olden days. That's when grandmothers were our mothers and fathers. Baseball was baseball, and America was apple pie. Now it's
the other way around.
Yeah, something like that. Apple pie was American. Spirit of America. But now it's McDonald's, of course. And you know what else is American? Back Porch Video Softball. We want you to get out and, well, on second thought, don't come and take a look at us. We're what, 0-9?
Is it 7? I thought it was 7.
I think it's 9.
We play real well, though.
We play well. Yes. Okay, now, we're all on that, like Steve and Dino and Dwayne, myself, and Craig Cutler, and Kurt Vinup's on it, and... Oris and Matt and Mark Campbell, they're all on it. And Alan wants to be on it. And Alan, you're welcome to play with us.
Well, that's good. I learned a lot of baseball.
Anything could be an improvement. Can you catch?
Catch what?
Can you dribble? All you have, the prerequisite to be on the team is you have to know how to dribble and you got to walk. You got to be able to walk.
Okay.
Don't swing at anything. That's our new rule. We'll just get walked around the bases. Also, this Friday at Porath. No, Monday, that's in, 2 days? Yeah, Porath Field, which is over on Michigan in Porath. We're playing at, like, 8:20, so if you want to come down and see us. And we're sponsored by Hijinks. That's a shirt shop, and Back Porch Video is also sponsored by them. So they're in the lower level of Fairlane. Go over and check out Hijinks. Their shirts are awesomely awesome. Another note here that we want to talk about is dance parties at St. Andrew's Hall, and that's on Congress down in the wonderful city of Detroit. And also, Mike Haller and DJs those things. Also in the city of Detroit, we want to talk about, in cooperation with the Hungry Brain Productions, the Hungry Brain Productions present the Polish Army Hall, at the Polish Army Hall, Sluggo from Cincinnati, Ohio, 13th Key, and Son of Sam. Now this is going to be this coming Friday the 28th, at the Polish Army Hall. It's on Martin Street, 1 1/2 blocks east north of Michigan Avenue. 1 1/2 blocks north of Michigan Avenue. It's $5 to get in, Friday the 28th. And we're going to roll right into commercials. How did I know? Lucky guess.
Available at Muirheads in Dearborn.
speaking of getting out of town, oh, that's from the movie Fletch, by the way. Come on in here, Dwayne. Get out of town. Fletch, get out of town kind of glasses. New York.
London. Boston.
Chicago. Liverpool. Yes. San Francisco. Can you see them, kind of? They've got, like, they're kind of neat. I don't know. You want me to pull them back a bit?
Yeah.
There. See, you can see, like, the cities and stuff in them.
York.
Yeah, here, I'll turn them sideways.
Back up.
Washington. Nanoli?
Palm Springs.
Panama. Pompeii. Now, if you ever get lost anywhere in the States, and even in transcontinental countries, you can just look at your glasses.
Hey.
Oh, speaking of getting out of town, we got dedications here. Whatever connection that has.
Yeah, from our...
Lisa and Jenny, we want to say hello to Lisa and Jenny in Grosse Pointe, Dwayne and I, kind of. They want to hear some Depeche Mode and some...
Lisa loves Mark.
And some New Wave stuff, and...
Dwayne loves Mark, too.
Craig's playing Depeche Mode coming up later in the evening. I don't have any on my playlist right tonight, but I'll get some on for you next week for sure, Lisa and Jenny. And also, Jenny wanted to hear some Bruce. I want to say hi to Dana Fuller and Mike Fuller, and they want to hear some Depeche Mode. They're from Birmingham. Hello, Birmingham. Hello, Booth Communications. Hello, Dearborn Heights.
Dearborn Heights.
Sure. All the downriver areas. Royal Oak, no gray areas. Okay, that must be some kind of hardcore thing. We'll see if Tony Boy wants to play. Here's another one from Troy. Up here, Adrian Shore. Adrian Shore wants to hear Crazy for Dearborn. And they're probably watching tonight because this is a live show.
Dearborn.
So, Adrian's crazy for you, Jeff. We want to roll right into our next video, kind of, and stuff. And the next one up is Climax meeting in the ladies' room. So, see you in the ladies' room. It's going to be a party. Be there. We'll be there.
Yeah. We got this letter from Birmingham. This guy, John, wants to know, what are you putting your hair in? How do you do it?
Well, Dwayne, when I'm very rushed for time, I usually use this kind of stuff. It's mousse. And, okay, let me show you how it works. May I? Okay, now you can go down to the Leader Knot Club in the Asylum and just look perfect, okay?
Dwayne Fatale, a new man. Thanks, Mark.
But when I don't have as much time, I call up Matt Orris, and he throws together a little concoction for me, and it goes something like this. Now, what do you got here today, Matt?
Well, first we've got this Kiwi Spray Shine, and you give two dabs of this stuff, okay?
Okay.
So you get a good
kiwi
look.
Kiwi Spray Shine.
Then you take this can of glass wax, and you just, that's about enough.
It's like a dab.
Yeah, dab will do you. And it looks nice, gives you glass a nice waxy shine. Then you take this leaf polisher.
Okay.
And this really makes sure, settles all
now
that
how
stuff
many pumps?
Down.
Is there a certain amount of pumps you put in there?
Well, it depends on how much air you have and how much you think you need.
Okay,
then you've got this Murphy's oil soap. This is the stuff part. Okay, you put in as much as you think you need. Okay, and this you just rub in your hair to make it all fluffy.
Now, this isn't any way at all dangerous. Now, how long have I been doing this for?
I don't know. As long as you've been on the air. And then you take this Outer's 445 gun oil, and you squirt that in all over your hair to make it greasy.
Now, 445, they have 480. Is the 480 just as effective?
Yeah, it's good. Then you take this WD-40 with the nozzle to get in those hard-to-reach areas, like behind your ear, and you give it as much as you need.
I never knew about the WD-40.
Well, you do now.
Okay.
Then you take this Dutch glass cleaner. This is to give it clean that WD-40 off. And that looks nice.
Kind of like a counteractant thing.
Yeah, four pumps should do.
Dutch glass, tempered glass cleaner.
Mm-hmm. Then you take this insect spray in case of any God's little critters got caught between steps 1 through 9.
And I remember one time you forgot to put that in. It was a horrible afternoon.
I can't help it. And you give as many squirts as you think.
Okay.
You need
insect spray.
Okay, I've been using this tanning for no apparent reason. It just looks
just
nice.
Color.
Yeah.
No.
And you put good two dabs.
Oh, two dabs. That's more like a gauche.
Oh, gauche.
Okay. Good.
Then you take this pine saw.
That's for the fresh scent. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Makes you smell real nice.
All right.
And you put as much as you feel necessary.
That would probably counteract the insect spray.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Then you take this Shout to clean up your collar after I made all this mess.
Because sometimes it drips.
Mm-hmm. And then you take these vitamin E pills. Well, that's about it. And then you stir it all up.
Okay, you stir it.
Mm-hmm. And what usually happens is you get one destroyed swizzle stick. Mm-hmm. And
no,
that's what you're wearing.
You're kidding. Okay.
No.
So let's take a look at the final product. And of course, this is just a small amount of what you normally use. The bucket is usually full. And it depends on the amount of hair you have. Okay, there's some just in the bottom there. And when you wear it, it doesn't actually look like it. It's kind of liquidy. Okay, it goes on slick, but in about a half an hour, it's hard as a rock. Yes, you can buy it. I'm starting a patent for it myself, along with the cooperation of Matt, because it was his secret recipe. But right now we want to roll right into the next video, and you're gonna need this video after seeing this. Okay, here we are. Yeah, of course I have my mic on. Listen, get down to the Leader Knot Club, and it's downtown in the Leland House on Bagley and Cass, because that's a hopping kind of place. Guy by the name of Sterling runs it. And it's a new kind of punk club. Also, there's the Asylum. And I'm not going to mention it. I want to mention it again before we go out. I'll tell you about another hip-hopping place we want you to be at next Friday. Okay. Also, the ethnic festivals are going downtown Detroit, so look for your nationality. And when they come to town, you want to go down there and catch it. We were down there last night. It was packed. There's just lots of people there. They have free concerts and all that kind of stuff. And the Grand Prix is going on, so Detroit is kind of a hip-hop in town again. What's the latest on the People Mover? Has anybody heard anything?
Well, big pillars everywhere.
Yeah, big pillars with track on top, but I haven't seen anything moving people. But if you know anything about it, give us a call at 271-2600. Yes? Commercials now. Okay, commercials now. These are Back Porch commercials. They are requested very heavily throughout the weeks. Go ahead, take them. Commercial.
Hi, Jinx. We'll print anything your heart desires on a t-shirt. On the lower level of Fairlane, across from the movies. Hi, Jinx.
Now you can lose inches off your waistline, effortlessly. Thanks to the new Super Walkman from Sony, the world's smallest cassette player. And while you lose inches here, with Sony sound, you won't lose a thing here. The new Super Walkman, indisputably the world's smallest cassette player.
Diffidence album. It is entitled Wind Power. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. We'll be back in just a few.
Oh,
Special treat up for you very soon, but first I want to advise you of some Hungry Brain Productions. Hungry Brain Productions present at the Polish Army Hall on Martin Street, 1.5 blocks north of Michigan Avenue on Friday, June 28th. Three great punk bands. First, Sluggo from Cincinnati, Ohio, 13th Key, and Son of Sam. Get down there, we'll all be there. There's no reason why you shouldn't. Now, this is where you find it. Down on Michigan Avenue, there's these cows. And they're big plastic cows. And I don't know if they're bulls or cows. Because bulls have horns. Those cows don't have horns. You look for those things. They're in cage, so people don't steal them. And then you turn whichever way. So you go north off Michigan Avenue on Martin Street. And you're there. It's at the Polish Army Hall. And it's going to be a bashing time. It's going to be great. Now, we want to roll into our next video. And it is Scritti Politti. Hypnotize?
I sure hope so.
It should be Scritti Politti by, it should be hypnotized by Scritti Politti, and get hypnotized. We are back in the studio. I'm with an old pal of mine, Gary Sibley, and Gary and I go back a long way. I mean, how many years has it been, Gary?
20 has it.
About 20 years. Yeah, 2 years before I was born, even.
Right.
Gary, you're a comic book kind of guy, and you do comic books.
Yes, I do.
Okay. Oh, you have one with you. And what's the most expensive comic book you own?
This one right here.
Is that the one there?
Yeah, this is a JLA 1. Came out in 1960, and I have it in its original condition off the newsstand. And it's worth $500.
Wow, wow. I'd imagine that's why I put it in the plastic. Now, what makes a comic book like that worth $500? What sort of things?
Well, you know, back in 1960, a lot of our parents didn't keep these comic books. It's hard to find it in its original condition like this.
Mm-hmm.
They threw them away. They thought it was worthless.
But really, it had a tremendous value.
Really, it was a hidden gold mine.
Okay, so you have a show coming up soon.
Yeah, it's called...
Tell us about the show.
It's called the American Heroes Convention. It's June 29th and 30th, 10 o'clock to 7 on Saturday. On Sunday, it's from 10 to 6. It's at the Taylor Sheridan Civic Center. That's 12111 Party Road. Be there. We've got a band there, too, called the Spanking Bozos, and they're really good.
Taylor Center, Civic Center, and I believe Adam West is going to be there.
Yeah, Adam West is going to be there. And
Batman.
And Dave Fing from the Pistons will also be there.
Okay, well, thanks, Dave, and we're going to roll right into our... Gary, 20 years, and his old nickname back when we used to play stickball on the street used to be Dave. We want to roll right now into Dean Ray and In La La, the brother of Ray Ban.
When you start down every day.
That hurt. Did you see my face glow? Anyway, 271-2600. Take a picture of me. 271-2600 is our request line. Requests and dedications are welcome. Give us some calls and tell us what you want to hear. We'd be glad to play them for you in the week or so to come.
Dave, play up my camera.
Also, Ace Awards coming up. I know, plug your contest. This is Steve Herniak, by the way. You want to come down here? What do you use in your hair?
I use cow manure and postulated beef.
Well, that's encouraging. We have the Ace Award up here that we won a few weeks ago, and be looking forward to the Ace Award splash party at the Hyatt Regency in Dearborn. We don't have a date right now, but we will be getting you one in the future. Say hi to Jenny and Vicky, the mystery girls called, and for Tammy.
Al, look at the monitor.
Okay. And just one more time by Tom. Right now, we want to roll into our next video. It's our last one. Don Henley, all she wants to do is dance. Alan, roll away. Okay, we're just about out of time here, but first of all, I want to mention the Steve and Dino Dream Date Contest. Now, the limit is 25,000 letters, so get your letter in and win a free dream date with Steve and Dino. You go out to dinner, free chauffeur-driven limousine with the disco ball spinning in the lights and all that kind of stuff. And so write in, 25 words or less, why you want to go out with those guys. I know 25 words is a lot of words, but do your best and get them in here. 15200 Mercantile Drive in Dearborn, Group W Cable. For all of you that are watching taped, I'd like to say just about watch every week, because Back Porch Video is coming to your cable systems. And if you're watching live, stay tuned for 3 more hours with Craig Cutler, Dino and Steve Kovas. Pegs and Kath should be popping in, or Peggy's down there. She's on crutches. Call her and talk to her, see what's wrong. And Tony the Boy Austin as the Beaver. Oh, this is the most requested song of the night. Enough of that. So for another week of Mark Pratt and Back.